Hello everybody, welcome back. Ziggy plays Fallout 4. We're getting close. Seriously, like I did a few things off camera. Like I just did I think I did Judas and one other off camera, I can't remember who. But we have we have Hush left for Blue Baby. We're not Hush, Mega Satan. We have Lost Stuff and Keeper Stuff. And other than that, it's just kind of like miscellaneous, do certain things with certain characters. So we really only have a little bit left to unlock, and so we're going to go ahead and finish what we need to finish. Not on greed mode, that'd be a little awkward. And we're going to go ahead and do some hard mode, Blue Baby runs, and hopefully get Mega Satan done. Let's see if we can do it. It's been a little while since I last recorded. Last time I recorded was Silas. This is a good starting pickup. It's like an extra HP and some damage. It's been a while, like, definitely since last time I recorded with Silas, since I've played, so I apologize for any bad gameplay. We're gonna try to immediately get back into the swing of things, and hopefully get into a place where I can, get to Mega Satan and beat him, very quickly. I don't want to have to do a bunch of these runs, and my hope is, like, this I think is episode 95, that maybe we can finish all the Mega Satan stuff by episode 96, or by episode 100. That would be pretty cool, maybe do something special for that, I don't know. We'll see. Who knows? We'll try to figure it out. What do we want to do with Blue Baby here? Well, he's going to be getting deals with the devil anyway. Regardless. So giving them up for deals with the angel, not necessarily a bad idea. We don't have all the HP to give away in the world as is. But if we can find, like, a perks pill and a self-sacrifice room, we can make some stuff happen. We just have to be careful about it. Getting some form of, like, HP regen. Get, like, Satanic Bible, or, it's been so long I can't even remember the name of it, Book of Revelations, then we'd be in a good spot, that kind of stuff, Relic, Mitre, all that greatness, that'd be really good, especially if we want to go that route, and if we go that route, we can more likely take Deals of the Devil, though it's still unlikely, because, like, if we're gonna take Deals of the Devil, we're gonna be low on HP. So, doing self-sacrifice rooms is going to be very unlikely. It goes in kind of the opposite direction as well. If we try to do self-sacrifice rooms, we're just not going to have the HP to give to deals with the devil. Provided we don't end up with something like an Abaddon payout or something, and near the end of one of our deals with the devil or something like that. So we're getting really lucky with these tinted rocks. Whether or not we get another bomb, which we didn't. To blow that up is whatever. But we have, I think, two tinted rocks on this floor. We're not going to get the bombs to get them, unfortunately. We did get an extra spirit heart from the end, from our item room, which was really nice. It's a good start. And cube meat, not a bad pickup for Blue Baby. It's better than a straight HP upgrade. We're going to have a thing that we can keep with us their entire game. It's an orbital. It's a good orbital. Brings us one step closer to getting maybe a ball of bandages. Or not a ball of bandages, but a bandage girl. So all good stuff. We'll see what we can do. Let's check out this room. So this is an interesting thing, right? We have two stone chests. We would love to get in there in case one of those is like Cricket's Head or something like that. Cricket's Head would be great. Any damage upgrades are great. The Fat on Mushroom is a good damage upgrade. It's not fantastic. I don't think it's going to carry us that far, so... I mean, it's helped us for sure, but it's not helped us that much. We do have Curse of the Unknown, so we should keep in mind that we have 4 Spirit Hearts right now. We need to calculate how many Spirit Hearts we have by the time we reach the end of the floor, just so that we don't make stupid mistakes and end up getting ourselves killed. I would love a bomb drop, if the world would give me one. Who knows, though? There we go. Alright, bomb drop it is. Cool. Love these. Please be something good. Able is not what I wanted. But, it is an item. We're paying an item to fight 2 bosses. Depending on how much damage we take, if we take any, could be worth it. But Able is not fantastic. It's extra damage, but it's not that much extra damage. It's not a Cricket's Head. Oh, that was a... No, I tried to get over that before the took damage from it. Alright, so we have 3 Spirit Hearts now. Keep that in mind. We got a key from it. Okay, it's not necessarily a terrible payout. yeah, we still need to be careful. We're going a little slow, but I think it's okay to take it slow on these Mega Satan runs. You know, we don't need to hurry up in, you know, in order to reach like a boss rush or a hush fight. We can take our time, do things the way we want to do them. We'll let these flies run into fires. It's going to, you know, make our job a lot easier in general. Cool. I don't know. What do I want from our boss fight? Because I'm not taking the deal with the devil. I'd rather not fight Krampus first floor. I'd rather just ignore a deal with the devil, go deals with the angel, and call it from there. But who knows? All right. Come on, hoppers. Let's go. Let's go. I'm in a hurry. Got things to do today. Oh yeah, we have an item room left on this floor. There it is. I'm excited about the item room. Could be something cool. Give me Monstro's Lung. Monstro's Lung is fun. It can get pretty strong by itself. I almost took some bad damage there, but you know, we lived. Fire Mind. This item deals more damage to me than it does good, but once I know that I have it, and I always have it, it's a little bit easier to compensate for. I think taking it, when you're worried about running into it, like in the form of like Pound Cake or something like that, it's a lot more dangerous because you're like, you're not giving yourself the space you need to because Fire Mind isn't always active, and then you end up taking damage when you're like, why did I take damage there? I think it's a better position for us overall to run into it as a free form standing item on its own. I like it. I think it's an okay damage upgrade if it procs, and the burning damage that it occasionally does is also good. So, we just have to be smart. We can't be letting enemies too close to us because we can't really trail them behind us without having to worry about getting ourselves exploded. Box of Friends, Stopwatch. I think Stopwatch is one of those ones that it can win you the run, so it's kind of necessary for us to take it, you know? If we can get the money for it. Didn't realize we only have one bomb. 13 cents. I'm a little nervous about this, actually. I'm like, oh, sweet. We're not gonna have the cash for it. Oh, okay, there's a thing here. Oh. No pennies. Poop. Okay, so we have to get a penny from our next poop in hopes that it'll give us what we need, or we can get Pageant Boy at the end of this fight. Either would be okay with me. I like Pageant Boy. I think it's pretty good. If not, we'll have money to spend on a different shop, and that's also okay, but I would love to have picked up Stopwatch. It would have made this Mega Satan run a lot easier, a lot more surefire, and I'd be taking a lot less dumb damage on rooms where you would take a lot of dumb damage. But we'll see. And you know what? This is a great item to pick up anyway, so I'm, you know, as upset as I am about it not being Pageant Boy, I'm okay with, you know, Magic Mushroom. It's a good damage upgrade, and it puts us in a better place overall going forward. So, Curse of the Labyrinth. That sucks. Because we're automatically losing a floor for deals with the angel. Hopefully, we can make it work, but I don't know. I'm not feeling too enthusiastic about it. Wiggle Worm. No, thank you. With these runs, I'm going to try to play it as straightforward as possible as to not lose out on these deal with the devil chances, deal with the angel chances. And not kill myself, basically. Because I do have to be a little bit more careful doing a run like this than I am on most runs. And that's why I'm most excited about, you know, getting all the stuff done. And we're damn close. I've completed all the challenges. You know, we only got 3 more characters to do everything with. I mean, granted, the 2 of the characters are the hardest characters in the game, and Blood Baby is... Blood Baby? Well, that'd be terrifying. Blue Baby is no joke either. Definitely no pushover, but, you know, considering we only have to do Mega Satan with him, and the other 2 we have other, you know, we can worry about on their own. There's the 15 cent. I'm okay with it. I think we're in a good position. I think that we can finish it off soon, and we can start doing goofy, weird runs, and not having to worry about nothing, and making runs do what we want. It's gonna be great. Great stuff. Whoa! It's a whole heart of damage. Where's the blue hourglass when I need it? So we got lots of money, a skeleton key, which is Good that we picked it up before we opened any of these rooms. Luckfoot? Cool. I actually don't really know how good Luckfoot is in Afterbirth. I know it was really good in vanilla. And I think because it's such a in-the-background kind of item, it doesn't really shine through. I haven't been able to really tell how good it is in this. Betrayal is, like, whatever. It's Betrayal. I'm not a huge fan of the items that we picked up on this floor. They're okay, I think, but they're not really, like... They're not busting the doors down. We're not making a grand entrance. This is kind of like a middle-of-the-road style run right now. The pickup from Petrified Poop is pretty good, though. Much more likely to get money and hearts from poop drops, which makes our you know, poop item a lot better than it is right now. Let's see here. We're going deals with the angel. We need bombs, so we have bombs. We're no short supply for bombs. Keep bombs around. Keep our eyes out for secret room potential. Could be here. No, can't be here. All right, good to know. We are going a bit slow. Again, doesn't really matter. We can afford to take our time. The only thing that would be really bad is if somehow on the next floor we gotta deal with the devil. I think that puts us at an almost like nil chance of getting the angel statues done. I have no idea. We might want to start donating to our donation machines and our shops, which we can afford to do now because we have the money to. Because it gives us, I think, a higher chance of deals with the angel as well as luck upgrades. And both could be good for us, so. And our donation machine is feeling the burn right now. It's not doing so great. I've been taking more than I've been giving, you could say. But, you know, we have a chance to turn that around, so we should. And what we get? Nothing. Perks. Okay, there's the perks pill. We know the perks pill exists. It's red and white. Hopefully it is. Hopefully I didn't just immediately forget what color it was. But that means that sacrifice rooms, self-sacrifice rooms, could be our avenue to Mega Satan. Which is, it's pretty big deal. But we have to find another perks pill. So don't keep your hopes up on that end of things. Oh, Jesus. Our size right now is actually terrifying. I'm not often scared by the size of a character. Right now, it is actually a little too big. Our hitbox is going to be far too large for us to be able to compensate for and dodge through. A lot of late game enemies are going to be very difficult to fight. By enemies, I mean bosses. Go push pin, whatever. Secret room could be here. Yeah, it's like a secret room position. Skinny up mushroom. We got the fungi transformation, which is awesome. You don't get that all that often. We are still enormous, though. I really could afford to be much tinier than I am right now. But our rate of fire is good. Our damage is all right. We're pretty run on the mill. Oh, there's the self-sacrifice room. We need to go to our shop. Now, I want to go to our shop for two reasons. We have lots of money. I need to donate. I want to give money away to our donation machine just because we need it in our donation machine. But also for greater deals with the angel chance, the luck upgrade, and a possibility that we get a good item. And on top of that, the possibility that we get a perks pill in our item room or in our shop. There's lots of good things that can come from our shop here. Did I pass the shop? God, we have so much money. It's a little absurd. We should be blowing up these every time we get the chance. Because we're going to get ass loads of cash from them. Again, I'm a little sick. I apologize for that. If I sound a little goofy, it's because I'm sick. I don't mean to be. It's just the way the world works out sometimes. Okay, I was gonna say, what do we have in these rooms up ahead? Okay. Good damage. I think for our rate of fire, our damage is pretty good right now. Alright, what do we got? We'll buy the spirit heart. We'll buy the more options so we get double item rooms. And we'll start just donating. Donate away. We're not gonna run out of money on this run, so we can donate basically our entire cash surplus in our inventory away right now. We're gonna get it back. It takes some time, though. Cool. No, that was great. That was a good... It feels very productive when you get to do lots and lots of donation like that. Alright. You know, because that's potential shop items for next, you know, potential future runs. So, good stuff. Yeah, I would love to use that self-sacrifice room. I don't see it being pertinent. I don't think we're going to have enough HP to do it. I mean, that does really depend on what we get from these boss fights. And the deal with the devil item, without having to take a deal with the devil, is pretty huge. All things considered. I don't know how that happened. Thank you. God damn it. Taking lots of damage. Yeah. Camping Conception is nice. The more we take damage, the more, should not be firing as soon as I enter a room. The more damage we take, you know, the more familiars we're gonna make. Extra Spirit Heart. Two keys. It's a luck upgrade as well. Our luck's getting up there. Our luck stat's pretty high. I feel like with a luck stat like this, it would be very unfortunate for us to waste it. And then we could potentially get some good stuff if we can make it to Mega Satan. If not, you know, we'll go whatever route. And because we only have Mega Satan to do, we're gonna definitely go to the chest. There's no reason not to. We're gonna get additional upgrades for it. All that good stuff. You know, you could get upgrades from going to the deals or going to the dark room, but it's a lot less likely. I like that we're one third of the way towards being in the spun state, which is an additional like 2 damage upgrade. I thought it was 3. I think it might be 2 for various different counts, so we shall see. Good rate of fire, good stuff all around. There you go. Occasionally get a spirit heart out of that. I have no idea how much HP we have. Shouldn't matter too much so long as we are smart. I know, me and smart in the same sentence. Fuck you, fire mine. Probably the worst decision I've made, but it has helped me through a few, more than one rough room, so I guess it's okay. I do like Tractor Beam. I actually really do. I think it's an interesting item, and I think it does some really interesting pushback, knockback style stuff with a lot of enemies, so... Does make enemies who you can't be adjacent to a little bit more difficult, but nothing incredibly difficult. You know, we can always just change sides with those guys, so we should be fine. Alright. See if this is a secret room here. Could be a secret room. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not having a good time with Firemind right now. Gained a lot of HP, but we've also lost a lot of HP. That's not what I wanted to do. But also exactly is what I wanted to do. Okay, this could be a nickel. It's totally a nickel and a black heart. One makes you smaller. Thank goodness that pill exists in our rotation. A golden chest is intriguing. I think I will do it for the potential of it being like a good passive item, but who knows? Now, you know what? And there it is. Alright. God damn it. There goes that black heart that we just picked up. Not feeling good about the damage. Why are we getting so many black hearts? That's the most bizarre thing to me. I can't fathom why we're getting so many black hearts. Does that have to do with betrayal, maybe? I have no idea. That's bizarre, but I'm happy about it. This is one of those floors where if we did find a sacrifice room, normally I would maybe like to try it out on this floor, but we are also in the unfortunate position of not being able to see our own HP, so we really can't afford to. Alright, let's go. Did that skeleton move, or did that skull spawn another skeleton? I don't really know. Would love to blow up some skulls. We have the bombs to do it. Okay, nothing important there. Alright. Okay, they're all dead. Good. I will check out this curse room. Okay, we do want to blow them up. It's a good thing I didn't have to use a bomb to do it. Just because it does put us a little bit closer to deals with the devil. Or not deals with the devil, but just getting a deal after the end of the floor. So that's always nice. Nickel. Alright, cool. Again, the poop slash petrified poop payout combination is astoundingly good. Is this perks? Is this perks? Okay, so we save this for a future floor. If we don't get the keep... God damn it, game. Just can't leave well enough alone, can you? I have no idea how much HP I have. I would love to pick up Black Candle. Give me Black Candle. Give me additional Black Heart. All the good stuff that I need to make sure that I can take this. Okay. Sackboy's great. Sackhead's amazing. So we definitely take Sackhead. Oh, it's a greed fight. I was not expecting that. But I'm okay with it. Just wasn't expecting it. Steam sale! You brilliant son of a bitch! Alright. Okay. Sackhead contains a nickel! Hero font card! Oh, we have to do it on this floor. We have to. If we don't do it on this floor, where are we gonna do it? Let's go fight our boss first. Before anything else. You know, just in case. We get something cool, like the mine or something from, our deal with the angel that we may or may not get. Hopefully we do. Okay, is this a run that we can make work? I think it might be. Also, let me check the seed so I can give it to you guys in the description. I'll put it in the description, don't worry. WBK307FF. Might be able to make this run work. There's still a chance for deals for the Mega Satan run. Still there. Alright, let's do it. War. So we're gonna get our second level cube meat. I mean bandage girl. I really can't overstate how much I hate Firemind right now. The thing I'm most worried about is the fact that I will have no idea how much HP I have going into that room. We know we've lost one. If we get a deal with the angel on this floor, I'm willing to spend some time and not take it to the maximum. Unless we get a ton of HP here. Ooh. Circle of protection is good. Alright, let's do this. Do we have the damage necessary? Are we ready for it? We're gonna get a deal with the angel, or we're gonna get a key piece. We have, like, 5 floors to get another self-sacrifice room. I think we don't do it on this floor in fear, and just to be safe, that I don't kill myself on accident. I think we have okay HP, but I can't be certain. And with that uncertainty and the fact that I'm hitting myself, I can't do it on this floor. What the? Okay. Let's go down to the next floor. Okay, here we go. We have a lot of HP. I should have done it, but it's one of those things I wouldn't have known, and it would have been a little too frightening. If we do get on this floor and we have a good amount of HP, I will do it. We'll use Perks Pill. We'll go through the deal with the angel stuff, or we'll go through the self-sacrifice room stuff. No problem. I'm down. I should be careful because I think as my Lux gets higher, these tiers will explode more often, and my Lux getting pretty high. So, I don't know if that's true, but I know a lot of tier effect based items do that, so we do need to be careful. Okay. Lots of keys, which is cool. We probably are set for consumables for the rest of the run. We do only need 7 cents to make a shop worthwhile. I don't know what this is. Luck down. Okay. It's a minor luck downgrade. We've had plenty of luck ups, so I'm not too worried about it. Stay a good distance away from these guys when they explode. Use the double key room. It's a one room, and I don't want to reroll this run. I like this run a lot. And it's another one of those things where, like, if I didn't have stuff lying on the line here, I would have done that. I can't do that here. Unfortunately. This is not a run where that can happen. Okay. Cool. Didn't get a luck upgrade there. Gotta keep our eyes out for those ambient luck upgrades from the donation machine. Really do a number on our run. Alright. We will have a double item room here, which is exciting. I'm excited to see what we get. Ooh. I'm actually going to take the piggy bank. I'm going to tell you why. As we take hits, we're going to drop coins, and if we drop coins, they have a chance to become sacks. And if we drop sacks, we have a chance to get basically every other consumable, including runes and cards and stuff. I think it's the obvious decision there. I love the blue hourglass, but I think with what we have going on right now, the poop is not bad. So, I'm okay living with what we got. I don't know if it's possible for me to get a greed fight in this shop. If we got one on the last shop, even though it wasn't one that spawned with a greed fight. Guess it is. That answers my question. Right away. And that's okay. If we get a second... Well, actually, we wouldn't want a second steam seal because there's not going to be any more shops for the rest of the game. But, that's okay. There's still that donation machine. We should go back and donate all of our cash to it. Because there's no point in not doing it. We should do our due diligence. Get the luck upgrades. Get to deal with the angel chance ups. I don't know what this is, like a faith up or something? I think faith is increased chance for spirit hearts. Or eternal hearts. But... Hematemesis. One makes you small. Something I've been looking for, so that's good. Okay, what are we getting here? Right, I already know what we're getting in here. Just, oh, well. Okay. That works out, I guess. That works out, too. Yeah, I would love to run into a self-sacrifice room on this floor. Will we? I kind of doubt it. But if we do, cool. And you're like, why are you still keeping this poop, petrified poop thing? It's for that. The chance at luck upgrades, man. It's too good. We could have, like, max luck by the end of this run. And also for that. Strength. Fool. Not great on their own, but could be helpful. Like, strength card can give us an additional spirit heart if we do find... Oh, thank you. We have a little brimstone now. In case we do find another self-sacrifice room. Stuff like that. And we do need to be on the lookout for self-sacrifice rooms on all floors. Which means I will be going back to see if that last room that we didn't visit... I didn't even see him until it was too late. We didn't visit as a self-sacrifice room. I don't believe it will be. I kind of doubt that it would be, but it might be. Okay, let's go back. Alright. Yeah, so... Self-sacrifice room would be great. Will we get one? Unlikely. How likely is it that we get to Mega Satan on this run? I think it's actually fairly likely. I think that we have a good chance of doing it. Will we be strong enough to make it by the end of this run? That's a different question. So let's try... Okay, it's not here. What do we got? Bad guess. No, but we do have a curse room, which I will check out. And it's two black hearts, so it was definitely worth it. Get those HPs. Oh, not those HPs, but potential luck upgrades. We do have little brimstone. I should be using him. Take the perks pill. Don't forget to take the perks pill. It's really... It doubles your HP when it comes to doing the self-sacrifice room stuff, which is huge, especially as we're going on to later floors, and HP is going to be of pivotal importance. But we stand to be okay on from an HP standpoint. We have like almost max HP. We have a couple different ways of getting HP even if they are a little roundabout. We do okay damage. It's not the best damage of all time, but we do enough damage to maybe feel less worried. The fires are probably going to be our main damage output source, or one of them at least. Should be using a little brimstone. There's another spirit heart. Nothing to laugh at here. Okay. Give me a deal with the angel. You can do it. Didn't expect it because of our weird staggered deal with the devil, deal with the angel thing that we have going on, thanks to the Crystal Labyrinth, but let's see. Curse of the Maze. Nothing too exciting or terrible. Just the normal stuff. We're very quick. The fungi transformation, you know, with all the mushrooms we have. A lot of good mushrooms going for us here. Okay. Yeah, we made a lot of fire happen there. Might as well check this out. I think there's no real downside to it for us. We get, you know, battery charges that gives us poop. Poop gives us potential sex. And so on and so forth into infinitum. Alright. Come on, Loki. Let's get out of here. Call it a day. Of course. Luckily, if we drop fires around, they should hit the fires and die, and all will be well, and we won't have to worry so much about it. Fire is a great, like, anti-enemy technique to have. Justice card. Bastard. Alright. Look, we're doing fine. We do, again, have to check every room on this floor, but preferably we just find the self-sacrifice room and are okay with it. Alright, perks card. Oh, perks pill. It's fine. Mega fatty room is a little annoying, but as long as it's just one mega fatty, it's not too bad. Oh, he's gonna get pushed right into the other fires. Perfect. Curse room is interesting, and I think I'm going to do it. Not really worth it, and that's okay. You know, we got a penny and a key, but ultimately we lost one spirit heart there. But it's one of those risks you have to take, right? Like, the thought of a free deal with the devil item without having to take deals with the devil is really, it's very attractive. Get away from the spider in case our tears explode. Okay, this could be a self-sacrifice room. It's not. Self-sacrifice rooms are going to be off on their own. Not going to be surrounded by anything usually. So, got to keep our eyes open for that sort of thing. Okay. What do we got? Just keep going. Oh, I launched him right into me. After the first few floors, once you get down to this point, those guys are a lot less scary because they just do as much damage as regular enemies. But early on, taking a whole heart of damage from a hit is painful. Okay, please be the self-sacrifice room. No. Could still be this direction. I wouldn't put it past the game. Putting it out here. Nope. Darn. Well, again, self-sacrifice rooms can happen on any floor other than the chest. So we still have, like, two more floors to search through. Luckily, we are feeling confident enough in our strengths that we're not too scared, not too worried about the potential risks of exploring entire floors. You know, the damage we're doing is good. Survivability is good. All the things we want it to be are there. The thing I will be afraid of is if we go to the next floor and we have Curse of the Blind, then we find one. Because that could leave us in a not-so-favorable position. Okay, well, at least that happened. And we are kind of running out of HP quickly. I do have to keep that in mind. Because we're taking combination of damage from assortment of things, but from fire mind and enemies and taking damage from being too close to them. All the stuff that we don't want to have to deal with. High Priestess. I wonder if I should use strength cards. Do strength cards give Blue Baby just a spirit heart? That I know that I've missed one at some point, but it might have been a pretty big fluke on my part to do so. Especially if they do give away, like, free spirit hearts. Okay, bomb and a key. Okay, we're gonna wait for these to come back so we have a chance to blow them up. Bombs or key? 29 bombs, 19, 15 keys. You know, both are okay numbers. I'm happy with them. Okay. So we do need to go back and check for the last few rooms just to make sure they're not self-sacrifice rooms. We're not missing out on all the goodies that we need. You know, if we get a deal with the angel on this floor, awesome. Less we have to worry about. If not, you know, there's still a few seams, but we're running out quick. If we get a deal with the devil, our only option is self-sacrifice rooms. So, keep that in mind. Fingers crossed. You know, it's out of your power at this point. I've done my best to make this run work out. Other than take, like, the worst damage possible. You know, I've done a lot of that, but... It's nice that our, like, circle of light here protects us a little bit. It doesn't do a tremendous job, but it does an okay job. Come on, deal with the angel. Come on, deal with the angel. I'm just waiting for it. No! Fuck. Okay, so what do we do here? It's the big question. Do we take stuff? Do we leave stuff? Hopes we get deals with the angel later? I think we have to go self-sacrifice route. Like, our chance of getting a deal with the angel... Our chance of getting a deal with the angel on the next floor is, like, below 50%. Like, well below 50%. And then past that, we can't. So I think what we do is we kind of guarantee that we can get ourselves HP. We have Dark Bum, you know, make us some spirit hearts. Come on, bud. So that we have HP to give away. So that we can become strong. And then if we can't get a self-sacrifice room on the next two floors, you know, we're just gonna have to... We're gonna have to do our best and, make a miracle happen, like, hopefully get Dad's key to show up or something. I'm saving this perks pill. This perks pill could be what wins us the game. So, or gets us the progress that we need to get. So we really do need to kind of work for everything here. Fuck. Really, man? Oh, that feels bad. Okay. There's a red heart back here. I think that's our last red heart. No, we have one in the curse room back here as well. At least half of one. So we should be able to get, like, one more spirit heart before we leave the floor. Yeah, one more. Two more. Two regular spiders, you piece of shit. Dark Bum, why'd I pick you up? Come on, man. Don't do me dirty like that. Ultra Greed fight. Alright, well... Wasn't expecting it. Got lots of stuff. Stuff could be good, could be bad. Just need, two clubs. It'd be so sad if I picked up a Joker card. Like, I should have just denied it. Come on, Dark Bum. I need you to be paying out with, like, actual things. Not, like, fake things. Yeah, okay. We're gonna have 6.5 HP going down to the next floor. Okay, it's an important thing to keep in mind in case we do get Curse of the Unknown. It's not, unheard of. What is this pill? Hematemesis. Don't do anything for us. Check for a second secret room. Okay. So there's still stuff that can happen on these floors. And stone chests could be a damage upgrade, which would be wonderful. We haven't picked up a ton of them. We picked up a good number of them, but nothing to, like, blow the doors off of the things here. Two spirit hearts. Blue ba- Dark Bum, you're a savior. Okay. Okay. Not the best payoff from stone chests today. Able, a few consumables, but nothing that great. Should blow you up. Okay. Nope, nothing. I'm really trying here. Like, I'm just pushing for everything, but we're not doing so great. And we get womb two. Just womb two, no curses. Kind of the way I'd like to see it. Another half red heart for you, Dark Bum. I need you to help me out here, though. Game. Perfect. Oh, Gimpy would be great. Old Gimpy. I'm so upset if we get a deal at the end of this floor. But I couldn't have known. Like, this is... It's one of those ones where, like, statistically, it was probably less likely for us to get a deal with the devil on this floor. For various reasons. Just because, like, if you had a deal with the devil on the floor previous, it's a lot less likely for you to get one here. Two diamonds. Cool. We'll check that for a secret room. It is. Secret room with a stone chest. Somehow the stone chest didn't explode there. You know, even more chance for sack heads to drop with these penny shots, penny tears. Yes, they do override, so if you are photosensitive, be careful, because these tears are very, very hard to look at sometimes. Yeah, I thought that might be the second secret room there. Okay, there's a red heart for you, Dark Bum. Goddamn regular spiders. Fool. Not what I wanted. Okay, we got Hagalaz. Not a year rune. Unfortunately. Curse the tower. Fuck it. Why not? I've already surrounded myself by explosions anyway. Hangman. Yeah, again, sticking with perks in case we do run into that, you know, the fabled self-sacrifice room. You know, super, I mean, I had the chance. Let's be honest, I had the chance. I didn't know my HP, but I had the chance to go in and sacrifice and get the other key pieces. I had the ability to do it. So if it doesn't work out on this run, it's all my own fault. I think the game has given us the things we needed, and I think that I've kind of squandered it a little bit. Not a ton. I think strategically I made the best decisions, but I think that if I had gone a whole hog for it, we could still be in the position we need to be, and I wouldn't be so worried about potentially finding a room that may or may not exist. So, let's do our best. Not give up until, you know, Fat Lady sings. Called golden keys all over the place, and regular keys, and keys galore. Yes. Okay, perks! Let's do it! Here we go! And we do have permanent Polaroid invincibility, so we don't really have to worry about Curse of the Tower, which is awesome. Curse of the Tower is gonna fuck over this, this angel in here. For sure. Alright, we should be getting... Not, like, super close, but we're getting fairly close. Feel blessed. It's good stuff. We're gonna have to fight two angels. The first angel's not gonna give us Jack. Because we already have the key piece from him, so... You have to be a little careful. Blank rune. Don't do that. God damn it, game. Why would you do that to me? Okay, there's our first angel. He's dead. Gotta do our second angel. Spirit heart's out the ass! Yay! Key piece one. Do we have both the key pieces? We have both the key pieces. We've done it. Cool. We have the full key. We're gonna go. We're gonna do it. We're gonna fight Mega Satan. This is exciting, man. We're slowly working our way out of this pit of fighting Mega Satan, and I've been surprisingly successful. I'm not bragging or anything, but like this has been really, it worked out for us very well. I've run into a lot of situations where I'm being able to do these Mega Satan runs on my first try, which is fantastic. I do not think that is going to happen in any way, shape, or form once I get to the Lost and the Keeper at all. If it did, awesome. I don't think it will. Alright. Out we go. Our luck stats, range stats are off the charts. Everything else is kind of middling, and luck and range are not known for winning runs, so we do kind of have to hope to get good things from our chest payouts. Fingers crossed, you know. We have lots of HP. We drop lots of shit when we get hit, which I guess could be considered a great boon, but for me it's not super helpful. We're the closest thing to an explosive hazard without actually having like a bomb related item other than Curse of the Tower. Anyway, I'm excited to actually maybe finish this run beating Mega Satan. There was a few moments there where I was like, it's not gonna happen. It's totally just not gonna happen. But I think taking our time, playing everything out, doing the things, you know, strategically most important for achieving our goal, I think I'm proud of myself for doing that at least. So, a little bit of self-satisfaction there. We still have to win the run though, of course, so don't count your chickens before they roost, and you know, don't wear white before Labor Day, and you're fine. Right? We still got stuff to do. Let's do it. I know it's after Labor Day. Alright. Let's go. Also, I don't understand that, but that's okay. Dropping lots of pennies, dropping lots of sacks. Two of Hearts doesn't do jack shit, at least the tower card when we get hit. We have permanent Polaroid invincibility. We can do Curse of the Tower twice. We can have twice as many bombs. Because how fun is that? Which I will probably use on this room because I hate death. Hey, death. Sucks to be you, bud. Or I guess not, because I didn't really do anything. Yeah, our damage really... I should be using... Little Brimstone a little bit more often, because I think he's going to be doing about as much, if not more damage than we are right now, so utilizing him would be smart. Emperor card. Cool, let's just use it here. We have no reason to do anything else, really. Who knows how long this floor is, we're just like, more likely to lose HP, stuff like that. Oh, and I forgot Circle. Life Circle occasionally shoots tears back, or bounces tears back at enemies, which is nice. Alright, I'm like, why am I continuously firing? It's because I have a little brimstone. We need to be charging that for when we need to take shots. Ow. Alright. We have plenty of speed. It's not something we should be worried about. Luckily, Blue Baby is a pushover. Oh, gotta get up here. We're fine. We're gonna be okay. Took bad damage there. And we're good. We've done it. Alright. We really do need more HP, I think. We might get it. We might also get some good items. So let's, fingers crossed, good stuff from the chest. Good stuff from the chest. Rainbow Baby. Zodiac. Eden's Blessing. Mighty Hats. These are not the boons that I needed. And because we have such high luck and things of that sort, I'm actually gonna go to these other floors, these other rooms on the floor, and hopefully find some other things to upgrade our run with, because as much as I think those items are okay, they're nothing fantastic, neither is Papa Fly. We're not getting huge items here. Not totally unexpected, but it's not what I need if I'm going to be fighting Mega Satan here fairly soon. You know, we're going to need more damage. Okay. Flush is cute, but I don't think it's gonna do anything for us. It's good for like a room here. Okay, got a Gertie fight. Nothing too bad. Rainbow maybe does give us the benefit of having like slowing tears, which is cool. I like that a lot. I don't think the magician card does jack shit for us. We do have to be careful. Stay away from him when you fire. It'll be a good distance away. Luck upgrades. We have so many luck upgrades. Sweet. That's like 3 HP. Fantastic. 3 spirit hearts. Beautiful. I guess I should be using flush, though I don't think flush works on bosses. Yeah. Didn't think so. This is a... The room is heinous. And anus. It's both. Okay, he's dead. I mean, we have good damage. I don't think that can be denied, but it's not fantastic. We definitely don't want to take Dunce Cap. High Priestess is mom. That didn't do a whole lot for us. Not getting the best items here. We are doing slightly more damage than I was thinking we were, but I still don't know if it's enough. You know? How likely are we to get more of it versus how much damage we're taking? And right, he can shoot little. He can shoot brimstone straight down. Okay, we are really relying on the fire damage and explosive damage coming from these tears. Freezing effect is really good. Strength card is beneficial. Okay, just make sure we're getting lots of shots in. If we can get a freezing shot in, you know, by the time it unfreezes, we're in a good place. Cool. Time to jump. Piece of shit. Alright. What we got? Sun card. Cool. Do our best to avoid big rooms. I think it would be another Gertie fight. Be good for us. I think with luck, a luck set as high as ours, we kind of need to finish out the floor because we're gonna get consumable drops like every single floor or every single room. Still a little nervous though. Will we have enough damage to beat Mega Satan? Find out next time. No, we're not ending the episode. Oh, God. Hero font. Fantastic. I was like, we're not spawning as many spirit hearts as we need to. Help. Help. We're doing okay. Okay, we're gonna get a card from these guys, or a Bob's Rotten Head drop? One of the two? I mean, I guess Bob's Rotten Head overall is better, or Bob's Curse is not bad, for fighting some enemies, but let's do it. We've gone on long enough. Got a strength card. We're gonna do a little bit extra damage here. Fingers crossed. Okay, just fire shots in. Fire mid. Fire mid. Okay, first phase is done. We're doing okay damage. We really just have to use a little brimstone to do a lot of work. And the fire on the floor is going to be really helpful for getting rid of these mini bosses as they spawn. It's going to make that a lot faster. Alright. Just keep aiming it. I think we have a good run here. Very strong. Stronger than I thought we were. Is great. Okay, we do have to make sure that we're charging a little brimstone every time that we fire, though. Okay, and we are gonna spawn stuff every once in a while when we hit things. Oh, Envy, man. You're gonna have a rough time with that big patch of fire up there. Oh. Didn't see that coming. Where are we getting those fucking black hearts from? Alright. Doing okay. Doing okay. Never fine. Everything is well. Should be on last form Satan here soon. Oh, brimstone! Alright, we still have to do the angels. Should have remembered that. Still got the angels to do. We've already fought the angels, though. We didn't have a whole lot of trouble with them. To be fair, though, we were also surrounded by bombs every time, and causing, you know, lots of fire in small spaces, and all the stuff you could ever want from that kind of situation. As long as we stop running into the, you know, their light fields, should be okay. Okay. That one took a little longer than I wanted them to. Get rid of the hands. So, oh. Oh, didn't realize they were slightly moving. We can do this. Last phase. This is the hardest phase, but it's the last phase. The fires luckily stay in there, so. How close are you to dead? Be dead. Thank you. We did it. Woo. Anyway, we did it. We got Hive Baby and Blue Baby up here in the basement. All right, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you enjoy the content, please consider leaving a like or a subscribe or just letting me know in the comments below. And I hope to see you guys all on the next episode.